All right, Underpowered Hour Nation, it's almost spring break. And that means that the Beres crew is about to go on a camping trip. And we've got our off-road adventure trailer in the background here. And Steven has been working on a new power solution for it so that we can charge our battery system off of solar panels when we're out in the middle of nowhere and gain some of our power back. It's been a labor of love. Let's not lie. So we're gonna check in with Steven and see how things are going in his world.
Oh, hi. All right, so this is our Vorsheer off-road camping trailer. This isn't like a super, super duper fancy, ultra expensive trailer. These are American made in Utah. They're all aluminum, except for the frame, which is obviously steel, but they've got great little side boxes. They've got lots of storage for your camping gear and your cooking gear. They've got a nice 23-0 tent that we've put on top, a 23-0 awning that we have on top, and then we've got some water, a spare tire, we've got a whole rollout kitchen and everything, but what we're focused on today is what's right up here. Now, some of the Australian-made, super-duper fancy off-road trailers come with ultra-complicated and very high-tech power systems. This guy, not so much. This is a very, very simple power system. And as it turns out, it's a little bit too simple for our needs. These deep cycle batteries, we have totally killed them. It isn't really very solar friendly. There's not an easy way to charge these batteries off of solar. So we're gonna spend today changing over the main panel to a KickAss, which is an Australian company, power system, 12 volt power system with a lithium ion main power battery, a 200 watt hour main battery. That's gonna last us through a week of camping easily. It's also about half the weight of these two deep cycle lead acid batteries. So we're gonna have to tear into it and get all this old stuff out. And then we're gonna put all the new stuff in and we're gonna do some wiring. We're also adding a 200 watt BougeRV AC DC inverter so that we'll be able to run my espresso machine at its full potential. Let's get into it. We've got some little torque screws here to take this, what is a main power panel? It's like a boat fuse panel. These batteries right now are reading 9.99 volts, so that's not getting anybody anywhere. These batteries are permanently cooked, unfortunately. So we're gonna go ahead and pull them out, and we're gonna pull out these cases and everything, and we're gonna get the new stuff all loaded in here. All right, whenever dealing with high voltage, you wanna make sure you give your fingers a good lick to ward off any potential danger.
Don't actually. Sometimes he is such a jerk. Just such a jerk.
How's that?
It's fine. It may have dropped on my face.
Oh, this is gonna be much easier.
Oh, it's just like on a little
thing. And it just like comes out.
That's actually really close. So you can take this out and work on it over at the bench and then install it.
Did you almost fall in?
Nope, don't know what you're talking about. Let's take a look at how the power is run from underneath. Are you ready? So this fuse box, this is the cable that runs from our truck, plugs into the port on the truck that feeds power to the brakes and the brake light system, right? So that comes into this fuse box here. And then without taking this off, it looks to me like there are breakouts here that go to all of the onboard lights that are on the car. Here's another cable that runs down and runs power to the brake. So you can see that they have these really nice cable harnesses. This one, for example, runs to the very rear of the trailer, which is for that guy right there. So we're gonna run some probes and figure out which one is which.
Oh, hi.
Hey, Steven.
Hey.
Are we sponsored by BougeRV or KickAss lithium batteries in any way, shape, or form?
We're not, but we would love to be.
This is a power probe.
What it allows you to do is send voltage down 12 volt lines, you know, just turn them on momentarily. And what we're gonna use it for is to see what all these individual wires that were never labeled actually do.
That's the one.
Let's see if we can figure out what this is. Is it this?
Mm-hmm. That turned on.
Okay, there we go.
So this is the power that comes from the vehicle connector.
Yeah.
And it comes in and it goes to each of these terminals. And then from there, it breaks out and it goes to the right side of the vehicle and the driver's side of the vehicle. So what are we looking for?
Does one go like straight up maybe? Does it look like it goes up and through?
Oh yeah, yeah. Right here, this right, junction.
Yeah.
So it does go into here, but I have no way of knowing which ones without taking it all apart. I think you're right. I think it's backup power for the lighting system. All right, so Stephen and I managed to feed this little cable from up in the box, came down, and now I'm attempting to get it to go through into this box. Aha! Ha ha ha!
All right, we got the BougeRV installed. We had to make some special aluminum brackets to extend it and make sure that it was anchored very well. It is absolutely enormous. Probably went a little overboard on the inverter, but that's okay. We've got plenty of inverter power now. Couple things that I want to do. I'm going to wire in to one of these quick connects. I'm going to wire in a box that will go up into our tent. We're also going to put a 120 volt box and a 12 volt box into the side box we call our kitchen. And that'll be pretty much it. That'll be this trailer wired and ready for action. Off camera, I did a little bit of more wiring inside the box. And we got basically like a uni connector so that all of the different circuits individually inside of the panel are gonna run into one master connector so that if we have to pull this panel out, we don't have to actually unwire the individual things inside of the trailer. We can just separate one master socket. Today, we're gonna finish this up for now. For this weekend coming up, we're gonna take this out for the spring break. So we're gonna get the rest of the front box buttoned up. We're gonna get all of the components in the trailer working again, the pump, the fridge, the lights, all that sort of stuff. We're gonna get it charging off the truck and we're gonna get it charging off of solar. We're gonna make sure that those two things work. And we're gonna get a 120 volt outlet on the outside of the trailer for our Starlink. And we're gonna get an inlet for the solar panel. And I've also wired in the physical disconnect for the battery so that, you know, we could disconnect the battery in case of emergency, but also when we're just storing it at home, we can physically disconnect the battery from the entire trailer system. And that way it's only connected to the trickle charger. We can actually tell this battery, it has an iPhone app, we can tell this battery to go into storage mode and the charger speaks back and forth to it and it will manage all of that and make sure that the battery doesn't get too low and also that you know, it doesn't get too hot or cold or anything and it'll alarm and all that sort of stuff if it does. So I've got to clean up all the grounds first and then make an independent channel for each of the things that we've broken out along these switches, all five channels, gang the things together that we're gonna gang together. So I'm gonna start with this here and clean that up and see where we go from there. Okay, well now the bulk of the big work is done. We're gonna go ahead and start pinning out the interconnect between the trailer and the fuse box. Now they use these little tiny pins here and basically, yeah, they're like microscopic. These are super high amperage pins. First things first, I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna strip, you know, just a tiny bit of wire. It doesn't take very much. And then we're gonna take one of these tiny pins and they actually go down here inside of the tool. And then you take the wire and you actually insert it inside the pin, inside the tool like that.
And then all you do is close the tool over, and now you've got a very strong mechanical connection that is good for 20 amps.
Well, now that Liza has expertly installed the battery charger, which is nicely stuck in there and ready to charge the battery, now I'm gonna pin out the connector. So I've made myself this little cheat sheet up there as to what goes in. You can't really see them on the back here, but there's tiny, tiny little numbers molded into this connector. And basically what you do is you push them in until you hear that little tiny click. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put some wire sheathing over top of this. We're gonna wire this one, which is our lights for in here. We're gonna wire this directly into the panel because it actually comes in through the side here. It's better to just go directly in through there instead of having it like go through the floor and up and over and everything. All right, so I am getting ready to punch a hole in the side of the trailer. That is to facilitate the entrance of the solar panel plug. We have two big EcoFlow solar panel arrays that will give us, well, there are 160 watts of solar panel power each.
There.
Oh no! Putting little covers on the back of the self-tapping screws so that you don't self-tapping screw yourself when you reach in here. Plugged in. It's all turned on. Solar panels charge off this one. BougeRV is providing some fantastic, huge amounts of 120 volt power. Master kill switch here, strapped right to the battery. We've got our beautiful installed right here. So we could, if we wanted to, we could go ahead and plug is plug right in here.
So what do you think? Are we ready to go camping yet?
I guess so. I mean, I guess we probably should, hey?
All right, YouTube. So in a couple of weeks, we're gonna take this trailer out camping. And we wanna know from you, what questions do you have about our off-road rig and how we use it? Leave your questions in the comments and then be sure to like and subscribe and do all those things that help this video get seen by other people.